This picture depicts a man playing an instrument. The world calls such people creators of music, but I call them creators of magic, because music is magic. It unites us, it transcends boundaries, it is with us right by our shoulder when there is nobody around. But for once, ask yourselves, do we ever think of these musicians who give us so many emotions in our lives, who are with us right by our shoulder when there is nobody around, who also have dreams just like us, but are shattered by the system, and who also want to earn money, but in the end, ended up alone in the street. And this story is very similar to mine, where I juggled and struggled my way into the music industry, but in the end, ended up in the rock, like lakhs of others. But in the process, I was able to see some burning problems in the industry. Number one, lack of transparency. It is the biggest culprit, and for a fact, even bigger than piracy itself. There is lack of transparency about the opportunities for musicians, the payment, where, how, when, and the data, what is going on inside. There's a huge dependency on networks and contacts, especially for the budding musicians, because this is far more important for musicians more than skill and talent. Third is that problem of accessibility, where musicians don't have access to their own fans, to venues, to opportunities, and all other things. And finally, the lack of a centralized database for musicians which can be used for all of us in a better way. All these problems together result in one outcome and one statement, that is, when a dream remains a dream. And this is where we come in, because we bring dreams to reality. Hello. Hello again. I'm Sumit Sao, the co-founder of a new era, a new beginning, a revolution, and of Plugin Baby. Because we don't just celebrate music, we celebrate musicians. So who are we? Plugin Baby is an exclusive online platform for artist curation to help them perform at live venues across the country in the most transparent, accessible, and frictionless way, using technology. So what benefits do we provide to musicians? Apart from being a platform which is transparent and accessible, we help them find opportunities in just a few seconds as compared to a few months at present. We help them getting payments in just 7 days as compared to 1.5 months at present. We also help them getting data from the unexplored industry and giving them information for the same data which they can use for their own benefit. Plus, we are using AI to find the true talent which is devoid of human likes, interests, and dislikes. Plus, we are also helping them in getting far more fans, almost 20x more fans than what they are getting right now, especially for the undiscovered musicians. So how do it? First, we onboard an artist. Then, we assess the artist based on 8 parameters. Then we rate the artist on the same basis, after which we divide into 2 stages, where one is adaptation stage for the undiscovered artist and the experience stage for the upcoming artist. These are the 4 market segments we are focusing on to get the artists from because of strategic reasons. So, is it really worth the business? The global music industry is of $45 billion, out of which India's growing market of $300 billion, which is seen to be reaching around $5 billion in the next 2 years. Our target is the $180 billion of live music industry in India. So, how do we earn money? As I said, Ad Astra and Experience are the 2 stages we have. The Ad Astra stage is priced at 249 rupees per ticket, out of which 70 bucks goes to artists and the rest comes to us. Similarly for Experience, where 150 bucks goes to artists and the rest comes to us. So who makes all this possible? We have a team of 8 people, where Anirban is the lead guy for AI and technology. Supi is the business lead for sales, for finance and everything. And we also have Rishi and Soumya, who's the design part of the entire company. We also have industry mentors for helping us to know the benefits and the problems of the industry. So, why Plugin Baby? To be frank, Raju knows this, that we have pivoted a lot of times to understand the strategy and the business model. So, with the new business model we have in plan, we have been able to get in terms of, right now it's 8 venues, we have got in just 14 days, and we have another 6 on hold because we cannot cater to all these venues at the moment. These are the few venues we have partnered with right now, and these are a few bands we are helping out. They are mix of college band, corporates, and school. The few benefits which we have, see the benefits right now, we do not have any direct competition, but we have a competition from the event management companies, which is the problem we are facing because that's the problem we are trying to solve. So, what have we achieved so far? Being frank, this idea came to my mind, I think, around 1.5 years back, where I wanted to see myself as a career in music and move ahead, but I could not because a lot of problems in the industry. So I made a team, understood the market, researched, I quit my job on 5th September, then got to IIM, where we IIM was the most important part where we actually understood the market, the strategy we are building and how can we move forward. And from there we also got investors who were strategic investors, the 7 venues, and we have around 16 shows which is offline completely, and we are doing our first official Plugin Baby show on 8th of March at Bug. So the goals we have presently are around 7 partners, which is right now 8, and around 3 musicians. The next 3 months we plan to run 20 shows per month with one corporate and college partner. We have got Price University and Accenture as our partners where we can source talent from. In the next 6 months we are trying to build a tech platform finally for the musicians, where musicians can find opportunities by the skills where venues don't choose artists. Artists choose the venues where they want to play. Then we also want to understand the data in the live music industry where it can actually help. Then the next 10 months we are seeing around 40 partners and over 100 shows per month with getting the AI into it where we can understand the likes and value of it. Next 15 months we are seeing around 200 shows per month and accordingly the app launch and the streaming process. So what have we asked? We asked around lakhs of around 40 lakhs of investment for us. And mostly guidance in the data technology part, because it's an unexplored industry and we need help to understand the data. Plus we need help in technology and marketing, because we need to build a brand around it. And plus we need help in getting a good team around technology. So finally I leave you this with a quote from Gurti Gurti Music, where which tells as to why we are doing this, and I hope I could tell the message as to what our company is all about. Thank you so much.
Doesn't mean no clarifications.
How do you really onboard an artist? What is the key criteria you choose to onboard?
So presently we are just seeing undiscovered upcoming musicians upcoming. So we have 8 parameters about creativity, musicality, technicality, and all these 8 parameters we see. Right now we are seeing it manually. So we are seeing that manually we have our own interest which comes up, because I like rock, I don't like jazz or metal. So I myself kind of deviate from my own point. This sampling installation process. So we have built this AI which will not do that, and we're building that right now. It's going good. We have done some models and it is working pretty good right now.
We also in the tech platform, we also get to see some of these artists perform on the shows.
Yes, yes. Correct. So what we're doing is, as I said, the tech platform where musicians can choose venues. So in that case we also help them kind of market them and brand them around it. So as I said, the issue we are seeing, which we saw in the earlier models, was that people don't want to pay for undiscovered musicians, because I don't care who the musician is. If it's only him, I'll go for it. But if it's XYZ, I'm not going for it. So this model is the ticket price, is not ticket price actually, it's a double charge which the musician completely gets completely free of food. And we built a brand called Plugin Baby. So tomorrow, when people come, they don't look for the artist, because the artist is already undiscovered. They'll not come for it. But the Plugin Baby brand will bring the people to see the stages and see the artist perform. Like, for example, say Coke Studio or Sunbird. The brand brings the people to all these places, not the artist. Artist is later, because yeah, nowadays there are a lot of famous artists playing there, but earlier it was the brand is playing. So that's kind of where we're going.
You also mentioned you have a discount with the event management.
Yes, yes. Because every artist right now is playing through event management companies, because they are the only way to go to venues. Venues are, like you will find, very bad musicians. And I have been through. They don't care anymore. They just say, because they have a lot of entries coming, so they will never take you as a key, a lot of options coming. So these are the places where these people have contact to venues. So you go to them and they contact you and you pay in venue. So payment comes in 45 days. Like in Hard Rock Cafe, it never comes, like it takes 9 months to come with payment. People keep struggling for the payment. So I said, why not go through them directly, go and pay in the venue? So we have been partnered with the venues where you can directly contact musicians and venues together.
Any other question?
Yeah, I have a question. So typically, right, disrupting an already established system takes a lot of effort. Right?
A lot of effort.
Right? Because the same thing what you said, event management has a contact. I'm sure that guy is getting a cut out of whoever he's recommending. It's that chain, right? How do you disrupt that when you say you're being transparent? So why would people jump at you?
So what we saw in case of venues, venues were even management companies, because these artists cannot be fined, they're undiscovered. Event management company are big fans, but they cannot, they are not doing it right. So when we go to them, they don't care who the artist is, if Sonu Nigam or if it's me, myself. They just want people to be there to spend money on food. That is why the market is focusing on corporate companies or this. So we can get brands from there, and because the brands come from there, people also come to the brands. That is where the people come performing. And then you build a brand around it and the word of mouth spreads and then you give it. That's the idea.
How does the revenue split happen typically today?
So right now what happens is whatever the artist gets, 20% is cut is mine. So if I'm the guy getting you, so I'll give like suppose 100 bucks, I'll get it.
And how does the event management model work?
So that's the model.
Pretty much it's 20%.
That's the model. And now it's
so you're good. Actually doing a better return.
Yeah. So we are actually
now the key here is more than the better key is making it faster. There's a long waiting period. But even they could pretty much catch up on that, but this model is that.
So venues cannot do parties. Artists will put venues. So it's the other way around.
Venues
will say that we have requirements, suppose in the month of March, we have 4 shows coming. So they will put the requirement on the website. Artists can see it, we can apply for it, and the machine learning and AI goes behind it to match the best artist to run.
They will give a recommendation, but artists will pick. That's alright. Thank you so much. Yeah.